Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. One, two, 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 two. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. All right, so.
someone has the super user password to set up two-way authentication for that is good practice from what I hear, but what tools would you, is there any tool that you would suggest that we use for them?
I have not actually used that quadruple per se, but that's a good practice. I would recommend that. And like for everything else in Drupal, there's a module for that. I'm pretty sure. VPN is something that I hate as a remote worker. And if you have lots of different VPNs that you have to swap around, log into this VPN, then you push something and you pull something from another VPN, the overhead that comes from that is just going to be annoying. And that's actually stopped me from working for a few projects. Like on the afternoon, I have to do a small push or something, and I'm not going to get the VPN. But there are good tools like browser-based VPN, which makes it easier for you, and preset tools and all that. But it's a good practice to have if you have an internet that you need your people to access. But in smaller teams, VPN is usually not that important. That's about security. The fourth thing is keeping their schedule. And that's what I discussed quickly before with people going overboard and working all of the day. So fixed work times, not too fixed, but keeping them around business hours, back and forth a bit, and keeping it relatively flexible, but not too flexible, is a good practice. So pretty much what we do is work from 9 to 5, and if we actually have to do something, then of course you get that time free and do it in another place. But if you allow completely flexible time with people, and the people are really motivated, they will work too much, and they will burn out easily, and annoy other people in the team, sending messages in the night. And I've actually had a call from a client at like, not a client, but a team member at 2 o'clock, like, yeah, you did bad work. And I'm like, come on, call me tomorrow. But yeah, like, you have to have some ground rules on the schedule. And it helps on pretty much every level. It helps with the clients as well when you're working on business hours, so all of the clients can contact you if they need to. This is a good idea. This is common knowledge in the remote work community to have an idea of good days work. Instead of going, I have to work 7 hours, I have to work, that every day I have to do a good day's work. And this is something that, if you have flexible time, this is something that's really important. So when you have the feeling that you have done a good day's work, you don't need to start for another task. And this is something that's completely based on the trust that you have with your team. And if you don't have trust, this is something that you cannot do. But for example, if you work from 9 to 5 and at 4 you have finished the task, and you know that it would take you a lot of mind power to get the next one going, you can just say that, okay, I did a good day's work, I'm done for today. And everyone in the team will appreciate that. Rather than doing or every day 8 hours, you can do more productive hours instead of just working on the computer and say doing like home without. Workflows are something that's really important for every team, even office-based teams, and workflows usually get out of hand really quickly. A good workflow is something that you can easily prioritize the tasks, but you're not wasting everyone's time. So back in Finland, we had 25-person team, and we were working on a project that had a product owner, and all of those 25 people were in every meeting. And we were working on Scrum, and Scrum is good, but usually this is the idea of Scrum. But usually, what happens after you implement Scrum is something like this. So we were pretty much losing an hour, a day of a week, everyone in a team for just going to different meetings. So we were having sprint planning, sprint review, daily meetings, and then we had backlog pruning 2 times a day. So that was a day out of every week. And that was times 25. So you have to keep it simple so it doesn't go like this. So either get a good project manager or split your team into different teams that have their own workflow. So this is the feedback from every developer pretty much on that team. And after some time, we decided to split the team into multiple different smaller teams, which use Kanban, which is a simple workflow, but of course, if you have a more complex client, it's really hard to make it work. And that's a really simple Kanban board. Your board would have five columns or whatever, but just my point is to not to overcomplicate your workflow. Keep it simple, keep it so that you won't lose hours and hours on meetings. Kanban. That's a name of board concept. It was like invented by Toyota. This came into the software development world. And Kanban is something that like it's really simple. It's a ticketing based system. There are good tools like Trello out there. And, and just keep it simple, not going too complex. Is there people working with Scrum here? How do you find Scrum? I think Scrum is great, but it has its issues. How do you find it?
I'm finding it really works well.
Yeah. That's good.
I'm trying to keep that principle of keeping a consistent pace. But just not doing those long 9-hour days. What's the end of this consistent day pace?
Sounds good.
And all getting together.
Yeah, that's what I mean, but there are so many different tools out there. You just need to find the one that works for you, and finding the right workflow sometimes takes time. So if you don't know what you're doing and it feels bad, then it's okay to try something.
Yeah.
As long as you don't do it all the time. So that's the main point that I want to make about workflows. To keep the overhead down, because most of the developers want to work instead of sitting in meetings. And usually if you go to a meeting, it's going to be so that the developers are working on their computer all the time when they are in the meeting. So, keep your overhead down. And then there's lots of other things that I could go through, but I don't have enough time. So, using the best tools, making sure that everyone gets paid well, and selling remote teams to clients can be sometimes hard. Reducing your distractions, that one's already there. And outsourcing is a tool that it's a good tool, but you don't have to. Just make sure that you're not always using it. So, to sum it up, I think remote work is awesome, and you should do it, but just do it right. Don't do what so many others do, and just, if you're a big company, don't let some people work remotely, don't create two cultures, and do it right. So what I want to all of you to get out of this is to embrace working remotely, get other people to work remotely, because it's a great tool, it makes working better, you get more productive, and together we could raise this number, and that's what this whole session is about. And I want to encourage some discussion after this, and if you want more information, I have a book coming out about this subject in a month. So everyone can go there and get a free copy of it if they want. Yeah, thank you. And then some discussion. So any questions? Jack?
Timesheets. Do you find there's issues with remote workers and how do you...
What do you mean, timesheets? Tracking time?
Yeah, tracking time.
Yeah. What we use is an open source tool called Kimeo. We track time like for client work, but when we do our internal things, then it's all based on trust. We just say how much about the work. But when we track our work with clients, we use a time tracker tool.
It's what was that called?
Kimeo.
Oh,
okay. Kimeo. What's that?
Minute dot.
Yeah.
I actually found out that this one spammed from my blog to zero. The people who wrote it spammed my blog.
Sounds good.
Sounds like a
nice
company.
Yeah.
No, that's it. I know.
Anything else?
What about tools like Yammer and the Box?
Yeah. So did you use that during your process for sharing files, managing versions of documents?
Yes. Sharing files and having file access is really important. For development purposes, we use our own hosted version of GitLab, and that's great for like our purposes. But for files, if you have documents and all that stuff, we've been using Google Doc, which is a Google service, so it's pretty much available anywhere, and it tracks your revisions as well. So that's what we've been using. And if you have any better solutions, I'd love to hear.
We usually use Box.
Box.
Yeah. Because we have a company, we bought the package, but it gives about 10 gigabytes free. I think Google Doc gives more, but we found that works really well, especially to control different sort of access levels,
yeah.
You know, giving it out to the client for a certain period of time. Google, even if they had to access some of the documents, they
yeah.
can upload stuff, and we can control it with the comments and so forth. So
yeah.
We found that pretty well, and we use Yammer more for the sort of the fun stuff or even links that we find around. So we usually use Yammer and tag it with a hashtag. So you know, some whatever is being sent today here, I'm going to put up those notes
yeah.
on my phone on Yammer, and everyone else in the company can access it. So that's what we do, but I'm sure everyone has it.
Yeah, everyone has their own tool.
And I was just wondering, because you mentioned about video calls and chat, but in terms of, you know, just with working on websites or development and so forth, lots of files, you know, in terms of versions, updates,
yes.
And, for that.
Are you developing websites or?
Yes.
Are you working with Git?
Yeah, some of the developers. I'm not a developer.
Oh, okay.
The guys use it, but just in terms of, you know, even
files
yeah.
and
simple stuff, because LinkedIn not plans, but
yeah,
like, you know, for their files to come out securely, and you know, sometimes to give us their passwords and so forth.
Yeah, we have actually used also a thing called BTSync, which is BitTorrent Sync, which is something that is hard to sell to clients because of the name, but it's actually a really good tool. It's pretty much like Dropbox, but you do it yourself. But that's a great tool for syncing all data all around. You had a question there.
I was wondering how you handle on a big team. I know that we always try to hire people, but when you have someone that's maybe not communicating enough, or
yes.
I mean, oftentimes it's communication that comes up that they're lazy or they're not doing anything, it's just they're not telling you what they're doing. What do you recommend for like encouraging more communication without making it sort of a disciplinary?
Yeah, I understand what you mean. We actually have, like, do you work with Git or other? Yeah. So what we usually do is we encourage communication, but if there are people who are not so happy to communicate all that, we have integrations with our Git, so that every time someone pushes something, we all get that into the instant messaging client, so we can see that they're actually doing the work, and that's still not communication, but it makes it a bit better to manage, monitor per se, but like keep track of what's going on. And it's also good for like code review, so if I push something, then Brian is there looking at my code and saying that you did bad here. But, sorry? Sure. Other than that, I know that it's hard to get people to do that sometimes, and if they're not capable to do that, I think they're not capable to work remotely. So, and then it goes to the confrontation, and that's a fun way.
I have a question. Who is kind of integrating stand-ups into their remote working, and how is that working? We've been trying it, and I find it quite disruptive and difficult for everyone to work through that.
Well, let me ask you first. Are you using Agile?
No, because I do a lot of custom tickets as well. I'm not. I don't do huge development projects. I don't know. So it's...
What do you mean with stand-ups?
Yeah.
Well, what about the team and text being here? It might be more like big development projects than what I do. So they can use a stand-up and you can kind of do it. 9:30.
Okay, so you mean like a day meeting?
Yeah. And I've just kind of gone back and said, I can't do this, I need to work between 9 and 12, and we can do a stand-up at another time of day.
planned to be 15 minutes or 10 minutes, like daily meetings, but they got to maybe 45 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And that's good for the social part of it, but then it takes the time out of very much for people.
If anyone wants to do that at the end of the stand-up,
mm-hmm.
they can hang around and do that afterwards, but that would be really great. But when you're doing it remotely, the whole idea of standing up is to make sure that everybody sort of stays on.
It might be good to try, but like, just don't like spend too much time on it. If it works, then it's good for everyone. But
it's a good tool for Drupal.
I know.
And Drupal Commons is like a giant.
Yeah, I'm aware of it. But I think the key is have one tool. Yeah,
that's
a
centralized point. So we use Redline as our common communication tool and task tracking.
We do
Redline
class. If we've got Redline credit quick check, which is around 30 credit, it's almost perfect check for that if you're in the check.
How many people are using Slack? Mm-hmm. Slack integration on Slack.
Yeah, I think we're pretty much done on time here. So thank you everyone. Thank both of you and
what are you there for?
Thank you.
Yeah.
We actually use Google Hangouts for like pair programming, so we share each other's screens and we can see what we are doing. And then, if, as long as it doesn't go too like, yeah, I think it works. It's kind of hard. Yeah. Yeah. We did something like with Google Drive that we actually put the code there, but there's no code syntax or anything, so it's kind of hard. But we like you can both do it on the same time. And if you find a better tool for that, I would be really happy to hear it. So if it was PHP Storm or something that you could work together, you know, that would be really fun. Not too much.
I actually ended up almost missing your presentation.
No, but I got it there, so I'm gonna put it up.
Oh, that's right.
We do our entire team is remote. We built the team. The company's built as a streaming company. So whatever
that's not good.
That's not good.
But
yeah, your presentation's going to be online.
Yeah, I'm going to put it on. I'm going to tweet about it on the Triple South. So
And which company are you?
Reality Loop.
Okay.
So it's
where you start? Where are you based from?
In Melbourne. We're just three people now.
Okay.
But I was before I was in a much bigger company.
Wrong,
but
you can
in
Finland.
And we had
lots of
Tiago.
Oh yeah, no, I met a couple of you guys.
Oh yeah, they're Pune. They're out in Denver.
Thanks. Do you have the contact number of the contact information of the company?
Yeah.
Trying to get in touch with them.
Do you remember the name?
It's very hard.
Pooja is one of them.
No, it was Finnish guy. Finnish guy.
Finnish guy.
Antti. Yeah.
I think he actually quit.
Oh really?
Okay. But I can get you in touch with someone if you want.